Hey, bro.
Thank you.
Looks like we came at a bad time. Let's get out of here.
Hey, York.
We saw someone.
We really did.
Isaac? Isaiah? What exactly did you see?
Someone in the forest.
Standing under Anna's tree.
Not a goddess.
A little different.
A ghost?
Yeah, maybe it was a ghost.
Ghost? What makes you think that?
We found this on the ground there.
Would a ghost drop this?
Let me see. It's blurry and out of focus. I can make out two people, but not their faces. So that's why they think it was a ghost. But then who was under Anna's tree?
A ghost?
Yeah, maybe it was a ghost.
I'm sorry to tell you that she wasn't a ghost.
You met her?
Who was it?
Do you want to know?
I want to know.
I want to know too.
It was Carol in the forest. I think she wanted to meet the goddess too.
Oh, so it was Carol.
Oh, Carol and Anna were friends.
Does that clear everything up for you?
Yeah, that clears it up. Thank you.
I'm scared of ghosts, but not of Carol. Thank you.
Good.
We'll give you this.
We can give you this.
Children's eyes are always so honest. It makes me wonder about the stuff we lose as we become adults, Zach. Is this your picture?
Yeah, it is. So what? I thought I lost it somewhere.
Isaac and Isaiah picked it up. They found it here.
Really? Then I'll have to thank them for finding it.
So this is you and Anna?
What makes you think that?
You've come all the way out here almost every day when it's not raining. You wouldn't do that just to look for a photo of someone else.
Impressive. Is that what you want me to say? And you're right. That's me and Anna in the picture. Silly, isn't it? It's so blurry, you can't really tell who's in it.
So who took the picture?
Anna did. She wanted a picture of us both together. I didn't really want one. So she pointed the camera at us by herself while I was moving around. And that's what happens when you try to take a picture like that. She was always so silly and happy. She took so many pictures. She always printed a load of them and gave them to everyone. Everyone just threw them away.
So what about this one?
You don't make copies of the blurry pictures, do you? We weren't even that close. But I couldn't throw this one away.
I see. One last thing, then. Where was this picture taken?
Where? Nowhere special. Anna's room.
Okay. Thank you, Carol. Try not to lose your stuff anymore.
I'll give you this as a thank you gift for getting my picture back. I don't want you thinking I owe you anything.
Zach, did you hear that? Why would she say nowhere special? She's trying to hide the fact that it was indeed a very special place.
Ugh! Thank you.
Zach, is there something here that you want to check out?
We need to be at Carol's bar at 2200. We're free until then. Hey, Sigourney.
I'm glad you're here. My pot. It's getting cold. Please, let's get going.
Here we go again. But it's okay. I need to get to know more about the pot, after all.
Very well, then. Hurry up! Look! My pot is getting cold!
Zach, has she been roaming farther and farther away from her home? Is she testing us, perhaps?
Now, get the car going! My house is over by the lake. 3, 2, 1, go!
There yet.
Don't you step on it! If you go this slow, my pot is going to get cold! This is not good. It's losing more and more of its warmth. At this rate, my pot is going to get cold! Hurry! Hurry! Step on it! Why do you have to drive so safely? Can't you see my pot is getting cold? Why aren't we there yet? Could you step on it? If we go this slow, my pot is going to get cold. Why aren't we there yet? Could you step on it? If we go this slow, my pot is going to get cold! Oh, thanks to you, my pot is still warm.
We somehow made it in time. But Sigourney, I just have to ask. If you don't want the pot to get cold, why don't you just stay at home?
Shh! Quiet! Things like that out loud. You don't want people to hear you like that, do you?
Sorry. I was just wondering.
I want the pot to get a breath of fresh outside air.
Fresh air?
I had a very wild student once. I was forced to lock him in the punishment room many times, and he didn't improve at all. In fact, he just got worse. We all hate being locked up in a stuffy room, don't we? The same goes for the pot. I'd feel bad for leaving a pot locked up in the house all day. It's the same for your job, too, isn't it? The more you chase, the more the criminals run. You hear? The best stew is one that isn't overboiled. Getting cold again? Did you have to talk so long?
Thank you.
Zack, looks like we still have some time to kill. Let's pass the time elsewhere. Zack, is there something?
Nick's still in the bar.
Just as we planned, then. I wonder what happens next.
Agent York, you're really enjoying this, aren't you? I have to admit, I envy that.
Agent York, Nick is leaving the bar.
What about Diane?
She isn't here tonight.
Emily, check that with George.
George, can you hear me? Nick's leaving the bar. What's happening with Diane?
No movement. Tell me what to do here.
Stay put, George. I'm thinking Nick will head to the gallery. Let's meet up there.
10-4. Copy that.
Agent York, it's Nick.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Let's go.
Okay. Time to play with the big boys. Thank you.
halos by now if I was driving.
I think someone's putting a curse on all the cars I drive recently.
Agent York, Nick's getting away.
Don't want the time to get serious. Hold on, you two, this might get bumpy. Is Nick here? George?
No, he hasn't showed up here.
What about Diane? Any movement?
No action here at all. Did something happen?
Yes, a little. But George, something's different about you. Are you okay?
Actually, I had a little drink while I was waiting. This is my first murder case, after all. I'm on edge, and I needed one. It was only a little, though. I'm still in control.
Zach, Nick and Diane are probably both inside.
George, you're sure you didn't see Nick?
Positive. I haven't taken my eyes from the entrance all night.
Not that I don't trust you, George, but I'm positive Nick is here. Is there another entrance?
Not that I know of.
Well, I'll go look for one. Help me out if you can, would you?
Ugh.
Emily, I want you guys to...
Wait out here, I know. I'm not gonna fight you about this anymore. But promise me this. If there's trouble, then you'll call us in, okay? You might not think so, but we're a team.
Team?
That's what I think, at least. And I'm interested in you and Zach. I don't want anything to happen to you before I hear more about you two.
Zach, did you hear that? She wants to know more about you. Isn't that a nice surprise? Amazing.
This is the entrance hall. Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.
Thank you. Thank you. don't want to die.
Yeah.
Nick.
Agent Morgan, where are you? Answer me! Come on, open up!
Call for assistance with the body.
Wait! She's still alive.
Diane, don't move. Don't move your hands and stay still.
George, it's no good. It won't budge.
Emily, stand back.
Thomas, call an ambulance.
What? A what?
Agent York, George, are you okay?
Yes, I'm okay. I think I'm too old to be an acrobat, though.
Diane looks okay, too. She should be able to tell us who did this to her.
God, I hope so. But you, George, quite a catch. I'm impressed.
Hmm?
George?
This piece of most unimaginable compelling. And yet, this is far more than a water piece of art. It is a piece of masterpiece by Alison
Gunnison
and Paul. Tom Croker. Very good speech.
Diane!
Stop right there, Nick. You're under arrest for the attempted murder of Diane Ames.
Back off! Don't touch me!
I requested and
Thomas will need a body bag too. Nick, quiet.
Can you hear that?
Hmm?
He wants us to follow him. Shall we follow, Zach?
Thank you. Willie, are you out there?
Kaysen, what are you doing in there?
York, is that you? Thank God. I can't get this door open. Can you unlock it from your side?
Kaysen, stand away from the door.
Where's Diane? And what are you doing here?
I was going to ask you the same thing.
Well, let's just say I have my reasons, you know, private reasons. I don't really have to tell you, do I?
Actually, you do. Diane just died a moment ago.
What?
You're not just a key witness now. You're now a suspect. And you need to tell me exactly what you were doing here.
Well, I just came here to talk with Diane. To have a conversation.
And I suppose that kiss mark on your cheek is from your conversation.
This was just a spur-of-the-moment thing.
Which is exactly what killed Diane.
Okay. I came here to be with Diane. You happy now? We've been together before, a couple times. It's one of the reasons why I like coming to this town, see? This time is no different. I bumped into her in a bar in Seattle. I had some holiday coming up. Well, so I just took it and I drove her back here. I have a wife, you know, but we've been separated for a while. We're going through a divorce right now, and I don't want her lawyer finding out. Anyway, how could I kill Diane if I was in a room locked from the outside? 2 hours ago, me and Diane, we were taking it easy, drinking upstairs. We were, you know, enjoying ourselves. Then Nick had to show up. Well, then Diane had a sudden change of heart. She locked me up in here. I've just been here, waiting for her to come back, of course, but she didn't. I heard footsteps a couple of times, but they just passed by. Well, then I couldn't wait anymore, so I let Willie here out through the window. Then you showed up instead of Diane.
Zach, Diane has become the third victim of our killer.
And nada from questioning Nick. Nothing. Got no new leads from questioning Nick. He's taken the death of Diane really badly. In shock, the works. He claims to have liked talking with her about art. But he also had a problem with her views about men. He says that they argued, but not at a level that would lead to a murder. They were about to head out to the bar again together. While he was waiting for Diane, someone knocked him out cold. He has no idea who it was, either. Of course, Kaysen looks like a prime suspect. But that door was locked from the outside. There was no other way in or out of that room. Which means there is no evidence of his involvement at this time. He did say something else. The footsteps he heard outside the room were not heels, but a man's boots. And Nick was wearing boots. But now that Diane's dead, no one can back up Nick's statement. Which is why we have Nick in custody and have to let Kaysen go free. That seemed like the only option, at least for now.
One more thing, Zach. George looked terribly depressed. I guess this case is really getting to him.
He's feeling responsible for the deaths of Becky and Diane. Take his rules and confidence away from him? I wonder what's left. Well, of course, he'd still have muscle.
Mm-hmm.
Zach, let's get back to the hotel.
First Anna, then Becky, now Diane. I'm not looking forward to writing this investigation report.
Agent Morgan. York. Do you have a moment?
What is it, George?
There's something I'd like to talk to you about. Do you have any time later?
Can't we just do it here?
If possible, I'd like to go to a bar. Of course, we don't really have to.
A bar? Now that sounds like a good idea.
Zach, what do you think? We can go drinking with George, or turn him down and head back to the hotel.
George, that scar on your cheek. Where did you get it?
This? Didn't I tell you? Well, it's not from work. I got it when I was a kid.
A childhood injury. Tree climbing? I used to get a few scrapes myself climbing the big tree in our backyard. I used to climb it a lot. And fall out of it a lot.
This wasn't anything like that, though. It was my mother. She did it.
I'm sorry, George.
Don't worry. It's ancient history. The world is flooded with unreasonable violence. The strong overpower the weak, adults over children, men over women, and criminals over their victims. I have no memories of my father. He left before I knew him. My mother would hit me every time I asked why. And it didn't stop there. If I ate too slow, left my shoes scattered around, TV volume too loud, she found reasons to hit me. Hit me bad. The worst was what she called the tree punishment. She'd whip my back with these thin tree branches like a whip. Tree punishment was definitely the worst, I tell you. Just hearing those words used to make me shiver and want to pass out. And that's why I didn't want to show you those scars on my back. Every time after the tree punishment, she'd always say the same thing. This is hurting the tree more than it is hurting you. And me, being a naive, dumb kid, I believed her. I went to the woods to apologize to the trees. I kept asking myself, why is she hurting me this way? I thought long and hard about it. In the end, I just figured I'm weaker than her. That's why. It's the law of Mother Nature at work. The strong eat the weak.
But now, you have the power to protect the weak.
That's right. Perhaps I should thank my mother for guiding me into this line of work. York. I've been an arrogant fool, haven't I? And if it weren't for me, both Becky and Diane would still be alive. I could have saved them both. You know, it's almost like they died because of me.
You're out of your mind.
I invited you to this bar for a drink. But I guess this bar is my confession chamber, and I wanted you to listen. And to tell you, well, you must already hate me for causing all these problems and not following your orders.
York, I'm sorry. I'll follow your orders from now on. You'll have my total cooperation.
George, you've been as cooperative as you can be. You even invited an FBI guy to a bar for drinks. You've done a good job protecting this town. And the folks here respect you for that. Nobody can blame you for anything.
Thanks. I do feel a little better.
Hey, Carol. Becky is dead. Diane, too. We've got Nick in custody as a suspect.
Nick didn't do it.
I know. Carol, you took a locket from Diane, didn't you? A locket with this mark on it.
I'm busy, gotta go.